I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Oh, truly.
You didn't seem like you had the fear factor this week from Marius, where someone like Andy Joshua, Johnny Wilder, will they, will you get the fear factor with that? Give us a better performance from yourself.
Yeah, most definitely. I think every opponent is going to give you a certain kind of energy and a certain kind of, charisma, or it's going to give you a certain kind of feel. Like I said, this fight was really about moving and trying to get the weight down and move around this big guy. But like I said, Anthony Joshua, I'm going to be a totally different animal. So I don't like none of them. You know what I mean? So it's going to be a totally different energy, a totally different big baby. Like I said, we try to bring the weight down to kind of please you guys, the media, to kind of show them I can bring the weight down. But like I said, everybody's different. You see what I'm trying to say? I'm not lying to you guys, but you know, I prefer big baby at 290. So some guy already told me that. And I said, you know what it was? I did no weight training for this fight whatsoever, no push-ups. All I did was crunches and cardio. You know, and I felt like it kind of hindered myself because I should have stuck to my regular, you know. But say it's boxing, it's a learning experience, it's a learning curve, and it's back to the drawing board.
You mentioned Andy Joshua. May I ask why you dislike Andy Joshua?
He got what I want. It's part of the game, that's all. I don't dislike him as a person. And I know he's put on his front as a Calvin Klein model, but hey, I'm from the streets. I'm going to run him over.
So would it be business more than personal with Joshua?
Yeah, but you know, part of boxing is all mental. You know, you gotta kind of create this image about a person in order to walk through them. You know, Wok was one of those guys that didn't even speak English. So it was hard for me to even talk junk about it. It didn't make sense, you know what I mean? So I kind of went the other route because that's who I really am too. I'm a nice, loving guy. But when the switch comes on to be a killer, I'm a killer, you know? So, but like I said, I know AJ been fighting a bunch of bums and I just can't wait to wash him up.
The big story, as we know, this week has been, will it happen, Wilder, AJ? If that fight was to happen, who would you to be
Maybe ask me this a couple times. Let me think. Any damn body, because I'm a fighter. You know, something about I prefer AJ. Why? Is there more money? Is he not as powerful as Deontay? Or why? Deontay's powerful, is not enough money? I'm a fighter, man. I'm a warrior. I go in there with any one of them. You know what I mean? So,
who would you pick to win out each of those if they were sparring?
If I take myself out of the equation, from what I've seen lately, I think Deontay. And the reason why, it's a wild, crazy man. There's a whole bunch of windmills, and if one of them clips you, get hurt. And AJ doesn't really move his head. He's really stiff. He doesn't really get low on shots. He's not a great counter puncher. He does get hit by guys who are smaller, shorter, and slower than Deontay. So I kind of give the edge to Deontay as of now. But like I said, you know, Deontay is more than a natural-looking guy, 220, athletic-looking dude. And AJ looked like a small bodybuilder, a shrink bodybuilder. And muscles don't help your chin. So, you know, he's been dropped and hurt in sparring and fights. Deontay has been hurt a couple times in sparring, but not in fights as we can't really see, you know.
Reporting.
Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rocking with the best. Elie Seckbach. The wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. EsNews. He came a long way. All the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind. Competition. He abusing them.